welcome you live from the Full Sail University for another exciting edition of NXT Action. I am Joshua Bishop. Thank you for letting us be here tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a lot happening. New champions, new blood, a great match at National Wrestling Day 4, great action at Arrival. A lot has happened, but it's pressing matters tonight, ladies and gentlemen. We've got a huge main event. It's a number one contenders match for the NXT Tag Team Championship, as the Lucha Dragons are looking for one more opportunity against the Blade Runners, but they're going to have to go through the newest sensation to join NXT, the Dance Floor Dangers. And our number one contender to the NXT Championship, speaking of which, Kevin Owens is in action right now.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first, from Maryville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens!
Now, Kevin Owens got a rival. He faced Adrian Neville and beat him. He made a statement victory that night to earn his match against Sami Zayn at TakeOver for the NXT Championship. The term statement victory, that gets thrown around a lot, but Kevin Owens proved without a shadow of a doubt that he is one of the toughest competitors on the roster. He is one of the best pure athletes, one of the best wrestlers, one of the best brawlers. Kevin Owens has been consistently strong, but he's facing a man who looks to play spoiler here tonight.
And his opponent, from Alexandria, Virginia, weighing in at 272 pounds, Mojo Rawley!
Now Mojo Rawley is a man making his debut tonight, and he picked a tough draw to make his debut against Kevin Owens, ladies and gentlemen. He is on a huge wave of momentum, but as Mojo Rawley understands from being in the National Football League as a defensive lineman, sometimes to be great, you have to be thrown in the fire early. And Mojo Rawley definitely looks confident. This is a man who believes he has to stay hyped, to stay on point, and stay strong 24-7, 365. And he's got a huge test here tonight as this match is underway, and Kevin Owens is not wasting any time. But even though they may look similar in physical attributes, ladies and gentlemen, as it stands, when it comes to experience, Mojo Rawley is severely outclassed. He's facing a man who has faced some of the best wrestlers in the world, all across the world. Kevin Owens has been doing this for nearly 20 years, and he's, look at him right now. He's just manhandling this rookie in the ring. Mojo Rawley is learning a hard lesson in violence. He may be learning, he may have been in too deep here tonight to try to make a name for himself against Kevin Owens. And Kevin Owens is opening up with hard rights, smash mouth stomps. He's been in Mojo Rawley's face and just dominating momentum in the early minutes. Owens continuing to throw the hard rights. He's not showing this man any respect, not giving him any breathing room. He wants to prove a point to the NXT champion, Sami Zayn, that he is ready. And with the hard Irish whips, he hooks him in, lifts him up, pump handle neckbreaker. Kevin Owens may be looking to end this in record-setting fashion. And Kevin Owens is calling Mojo Rawley to his feet, looking for something big. Lifts him up on his shoulders. Wait a minute. Mojo Rawley is able to slip out. Here comes the DDT. Mojo Rawley is getting hyped. Kevin Owens tries to throw the fist, but nothing. Mojo brings it down with the clothesline. And another clothesline. Owens misses wild. Mojo ready. Mojo with a beautiful catch on the tilt-the-wall backbreaker. Mojo Rawley with the big splash. Kevin Owens feeling this rookie's power early. Mojo Rawley has all the physical attributes to be something great. And there's the crossbody into the cover. One, a very narrow two count. I'd give it to him, but it's still not three. It's still not enough to end the match. But Mojo Rawley staying straight on Kevin Owens, not looking flustered by the moment. Trying to knock again for Mojo Rawley, throwing the knees. And there's a beautiful suplex from Mojo Rawley, and he's getting hyped. These fans love it here. Mojo Rawley showing off an impressive display of strength as Kevin Owens gets back to his feet. Mojo Rawley throwing him in the corner. turns him around. He's got something set up here. Mojo Rawley with the Irish whip in the corner and a beautiful bulldog. Check the athleticism from this young man. He could be looking for the hyper drive. He's getting hype. He's staying hype. And Mojo Rawley is looking for the end. Kevin Owens looks to be in trouble as Mojo Rawley. No! Kevin Owens is able to slip out of this grasp. And Owens lifts him up with the Michinoku driver. A great response into the cover. Two. No! Mojo Rawley able to get his shoulder up. Side headlock from Kevin Owens. And there you see a beautiful backbreaker from Kevin Owens. A Uranagi backbreaker it looked like. And now Kevin Owens going up high. No, Mojo Rawley is able to catch him and throws him off with a power slam. Shaking off the cobwebs, Mojo Rawley could be looking for the end here. Throws him hard in the corner, but he doesn't have him in the position he wants. Mojo Rawley once again throwing him in the corner. Mojo Rawley coming at full force. No! Whatever he had planned there didn't work, and Kevin Owens has got him hooked. This is trouble, and there's a powerbomb right in the turnbuckle. Kevin Owens, though, doesn't look done. He looks like he wants to put an exclamation mark on this and say, Mojo Rawley, welcome to NXT. He's got him hooked by the arms. Package pile driver. Into the cover. One, two. Thanks for coming, Mojo.
Here is your winner, Kevin Owens!
Kevin Owens with a statement victory once again, telling the world he is more than ready for his match against Sami Zayn at TakeOver. Even though TakeOver is weeks away, Kevin Owens is staying ready, staying sharp, staying in shape, saying, Sami, if you're going to do that, I will too. He just disposed of Mojo Rawley. Mojo gave it everything he had. He had some pretty impressive offense, but it just wasn't enough. And now Kevin Owens grabs the microphone. Strong words from both Kevin Owens and the Blade Runners. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. We got to pay some bills. More NXT coming up shortly.
One, two, three, one. Wait a minute! Oh! Just got screwed! I'm in the NXT World Heavyweight Championship! Hey! Joey Bryan! Bandit Keith! The former commissioners of NXT! Yes! It's Triple H! This was a damn setup! The referee working for these three men! Of these three sick bastards! Here comes the powers that be! And now Triple H coming to attack Chris Hero! Shinsuke Nakamura gets screwed out of the World Heavyweight Championship! Chris Hero gets screwed out of the World Heavyweight Championship! Isn't somebody gonna stop this goddamn injustice here? Wait a minute! Oh, shit! Here come the cavalry boys! Off to take them to hell! Big Papa Pump, the Big Bad, Booty Daddy, Freakzilla, Scott Steiner! Standing side by side. Wait a minute! What the fuck? No! You goddamn it! Goddamn it, no!
Seen a mile of suckle the founding 16 penny nails. Truckers on the interstate have been known to ride the rails. Sweat is beating on the brow and keep these fellows down, cause these damn blue collar tweakers, they'll run in this here town.
Welcome back to NXT, ladies and gentlemen. Ty Dillinger is a man not on the roster, but he very well could be if he defeats this NXT superstar coming out.
Yeah, like I said, it's your boy Will B. God's Father mixtape. You already know how I do, man. I kill shit. Rip the rap game, motherfucking big thing, man. We got a rich shit with everything. Me, give a fuck, fuck that. Bitch, I own track. I'm a star like I'm a sack. I'm so sad like I'm a sack.
This next match is the $25,000 Swag Olympics. He's scheduled for one ball with a 5-minute time. Making his way to the ring. From Nashville, Tennessee, weighing in at 220 pounds, Dante Styles!
And Dante Styles is only 20 years old, but he has all the in-ring talent, although his mouth will make you think he is the second coming of Jesus Christ. Dante Styles, though, ladies and gentlemen, quite as equal, quite as arrogant. You gotta give him some credit. He's got some confidence here tonight to put up $25,000 of his own money and say, look, I don't care who it is, I'm gonna get the ring and I'm gonna beat somebody. And lose. They all deserve 5 minutes of flying time. Big opportunity for Ty Dillinger. It's really gut check time. If you want to put it that way, Ty Dillinger can make this type of tonight. Beat the beat this man. So don't take Dante Styles lightly, ladies and gentlemen. He may have a Napoleon complex, but he can back up every single word he says in that ring, although his attitude will surely rub people the wrong way. Now Dante Styles into the lockup with Ty Dillinger as the $25,000 Swag Olympics begin. Ty Dillinger with the early advantage going into the waistline. No, Dante Styles is able to slide his way out. Now Dante missing wild with a knee at Ty Dillinger. Now opening up with some hard strikes. Irish whip from Ty Dillinger. Ducking underneath Dante Styles. Setting up for something here, but no. Dante Styles is able to counter with a float over DDT. Beautifully done from Dante Styles. And now he opens up with a hard flurry of kicks. Really dazed him on that one. And Dante Styles has got Ty Dillinger where he doesn't want to be with a pump handle gut buster. And there you see Dante Styles showing off the arrogance as this crowd not responding very well. If they remember what Dante Styles was like in Iconic Pro Wrestling, he's definitely not loved by anybody, but he definitely has the talent as he's going up high for something big here from behind. Dante Styles with a huge Astro Scissor Whip. Nicely done, and now Dante Styles could be looking to end it early. He's in position. He's got Ty where he wants him. Hooks him. He could be looking to put some stacks on deck, and he surely is. Stacks on deck connected. This could be the end of the match already. Hooks the leg. One, two, three. Thanks for coming, Ty Dillinger.
Here is your winner, Dante Styles.
Now that's a way to make a debut, ladies and gentlemen. Dante Styles saying Ty Dillinger is not worth his $25,000, but you see the cost of this man's acting like he's on the World Series. I want to see him against the likes of real talent here. I want to see him against the likes of somebody like Baron Corbin, like Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens, Adrian Neville. Give this man a real competitor. I want to see what Dante Styles does to see if he runs that mouth of his. That's NXT head trainer Brent Delavine holding up a high standard. Don't worry about him, ladies and gentlemen. That's exactly how Brent Delavine acts. He wants to get the best out of all of his competitors, and he's going to put Baron Corbin to the test. And it sounds like Brent Delavine is going to handpick an opponent for Baron to face in just two episodes. But as it stands, ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Speaking of new blood, welcome Finn Balor to NXT, ladies and gentlemen, who at arrival made his intentions known when he stood in the ring face-to-face with Maurice Brown, held the gun up in his face, saying, almost like telling Maurice Brown he's next or he's first or whatever you want to call him. Ladies and gentlemen, Finn Balor is a well-traveled athlete. He's got a lot on his mind here. He's been given some time tonight to get some thoughts off his chest and spell out what exactly he is here in NXT to do. Finn Balor, as we all know, ladies and gentlemen, once we see this man in the ring, he's going to light it up. This is one of the best athletes. I say it a lot for a lot of people, ladies and gentlemen, but there's no doubt about it. It's Finn Balor. That devastating coup de grace, that double foot stomp from the top rope. He also has the Bloody Sunday in his repertoire that he can go to. Finn Balor has a lot of ways to close a match. He's definitely one of the toughest competitors, and now let's hear what he has to say. very bold words from Malik Brown. How do you respond, Finn? Ladies and gentlemen, Sin Cara and Kalisto have both been found knocked out backstage. And we don't know who did it or what this is about, but Commissioner Regal has already ordered for a substitute team to come out and take their place. The Dance for Danger are still going to have their match. But now they're in a really tough situation.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit, and it is a number one contenders match to the NXT Tag Team Championships. Making their way to the ring at a combined weight of 439 pounds, DB Disco and Super Kenji, the Dance for Danger!
Now you have to think for BB Disco and Super Kenji, who were excited to face the Lucha Dragons in what should have been a high-octane, fast-paced, adrenaline-fueled matchup between four great athletes. They're having to face a brand new team that they have had no time to prepare for or no idea about. After the TCWS World Champion BB Disco, this is nothing new for you, but if you're battle pro Super Kenji, you have to wonder, like, he's never been in this situation before, but...
And their opponents, standing at a combined weight of 436 pounds, Aiden English and Simon Gotch, the Vaudevillains.
The Vaudevillains seem to be a fitting team to go take this challenge. It almost seems too fitting. If you really think about it, ladies and gentlemen, it seems too fitting. Because as it stands, the Vaudevillains have had their rights with the Lucha. Lucha Dragons. They've had their issues, and they let it be known at Arrival, they felt like they were shortchanged. They felt like they were screwed. They felt like they should have been facing the Playburners because they claim they beat the Lucha Dragons. But all they really did was knock out Kalisto backstage in a rematch, knock out Kalisto to force Sin Cara to fight one-on-two against these two men. And I wouldn't be surprised if it was these two men that were up to no good that knocked out the Lucha Dragons again. I can't trust these two men, but as it stands, Commissioner Regal has called on these two men to fight in a number one contenders match. And again, we have no details readily available, but as it stands, the Vaudevillains are now facing the Dance Floor Dangers, and this match is underway. BB Disco is now going to lock up with Simon Gotch. The Dance Floor Dangers in purple, the Vaudevillains in green. A little bit of a Mardi Gras feel, although it was maybe 1 month too late, but as it stands, here we go. The chops and kicks being traded early. Simon Gotch, back and forth both of these men go. Here we go, Simon Gotch now overpowering BB Disco with the chops. But no, BB Disco is able to fight him off. This is wild with the drop kick though, and now Simon Gotch in prime position as he continues to unload on the TCW Aster World Champion, the Terror Dome's ace, with repeated chops. And again, a hard chop. It's like a skillet going across your chest, and Simon Gotch showing off the strength. Flexing for the crowd as now Simon Gotch goes into the Irish Whip. Ducks underneath BB Disco. Ducks underneath BB Disco again. Ducks a third time, and he's showing off once again as BB Disco is saying, put your money where your mouth is with that strength on the super kick. Now BB Disco opening up with a flurry of kicks. The Lucha Libre Funky Athlete getting this underway as BB Disco with the Irish Whip in the corner. BB Disco with an impressive leap. Beautifully done there with the strikes. And now into the monkey flip. BB Disco showing exactly the world, the NXT Universe, what he's all about as he hits the jawbreaker there. Follows up with the elbow drop and the impressive kip up. This is what a well-seasoned, well-traveled athlete like BB Disco is all about as he gets him in the corner, making the quick tag to Super Kenji from the Red Light District in Tokyo, Japan. Atomic drop and a big boot to follow from the Dance Floor Dangers. Great combination into the cover. Two, no. Simon Gotch able to get his shoulder up, and now you see Super Kenji into the swinging neck breaker. This is a man from Battle Pro, ladies and gentlemen. So you know Super Kenji is a tough athlete. You know Battle Pro has got a lot of guys over there from Nashville, from the Danger Zone, who are definitely tough in their own right. And Super Kenji now opening up with the strikes, taking Simon Gotch on the ropes. Irish Whip comes as, look at the athleticism from Super Kenji off the springboard crossbody. And Super Kenji definitely feeling the momentum as he goes up high, but Simon Gotch is able to catch him with a hard chop. One chop was all it took to stun him, and now Simon Gotch going up high with the super flex. Super Kenji getting up to his feet as now Simon Gotch with the back suplex holding the bridge. Almost a two count there, like one and a half. Goes to show you how tough Super Kenji is and how quick he was able to respond. Tried to kick, but nothing there. Simon Gotch was beautifully ready for it. Snap suplex from Simon Gotch as the Vaudevillains have now taken control of the match. One elbow drop from Simon Gotch, quickly following up with another. The Vaudevillains are going to look to cut the ring in half, and that would definitely be a smart idea, especially against the newest debuting team here in NXT, as Aiden English is in the match following a double neck breaker. Aiden English now with the stomp to the gut and then the elbow. Ladies and gentlemen, now you see Aiden English with the hard knee. Super Kenji in trouble as the Vaudevillains look at where they've been this past minute. They have been in their corner of the ring, isolating Super Kenji away from BB Disco as Simon Gotch continues that solid strategy, and the Vaudevillains making their impact, showing how badly they want to be the number one contenders. They want to prove themselves. They want the NXT Tag Team Championships. Who could blame them? Tag now made to Simon Gotch, and there's the hard shot to the gut from Simon Gotch. WEDF has been known for a great diverse tag division, and it's looking no different here in NXT. Simon Gotch once again following the backbreaker with the elbow drop. Now he's got a choke. Nicely done there, using his legs to choke Super Kenji there and then deliver a hard elbow shot. And you see Simon Gotch again, the vaudevillains continuing the pressure. Constant tags, keeping Super Kenji on their side of the ring. And they show an impressive display of strength with the double hip toss, and now Aiden English showing off to the crowd. But Super Kenji is able to recover. The resilience finally kicking in for the Danger Zone product. Super Kenji firing up as the Japanese playboy got him with the back suplex. Nicely done, backdrop suplex. And now he's gonna get the tag with him in the corner. BB Disco with the assist on the roundhouse. And now Super Kenji following the scoop slam, and the leg drop connects, brother. Now BB Disco looking at Simon Gotch. Simon Gotch tried to get involved, but BB Disco was quickly able to knock him down and keep him isolated. As Super Kenji finally getting some revenge back against Aiden English. Tag now made to the fresh man, BB Disco. He's got him set for something big. Look at the athleticism from the Dance Floor Dangers on the dropkick STO combination into the cover. One, two, no, it's not enough to do it though. As beautiful as that move was, it was just not good enough. The guaranteed victory is now BB Disco back in the ring against Aiden English. Showing up once again to the crowd, the charismatic showman from the Terror Dome, BB Disco, with the beautiful athleticism on display, setting up for something big here, but no! Simon Gotch is able to catch a BB Disco, going too far towards Simon Gotch. He looked like he was setting up again for a monkey flip, but wasn't there, as Aiden English was able to fight his way out of the Dance Floor Dangerous corner and bring down BB Disco with the shoulder block. Great heads-up awareness from Simon Gotch, and now he gets the tag with the assisted big boot. Give the vaudevillains credit here. They're definitely countering the Dance Floor Dangerous momentum here. It looked like the Dance Floor Dangerous had something going. Looked like they were fixing to make the comeback, but the vaudevillains were able to cut it off short. Following the hard Irish whip, Simon Gotch now driving those knees right in the face of BB Disco. And now BB Disco is the one in trouble here. A hard Irish whip from Simon Gotch. Simon Gotch having to react quickly to take BB Disco's strength out of him. And he lifts him up on his shoulders, spinning him around. The airplane spin, the whirly birds are out, ladies and gentlemen, as Simon Gotch slams BB Disco back first on the mat. This could do it. One, two, but no. Super Kenji was right there to break it up. And now you see Simon Gotch again into the snap suplex, dragging BB Disco away from the corner. Gonna make the tag to Aiden English. Aiden English now in the ring as he just rakes his boot across BB Disco, trying to get the dirt off the bottom of his shoe and just treat BB Disco like dirt while we're at it. And now you see Aiden English, oh my goodness, into another snap suplex-like maneuver there. Just both of these men are punishing BB Disco right now. The vaudevillains showing how hungry they are, how much they want this. The vaudevillains are in control as Aiden English crowns BB Disco with the double X handle. And now Aiden English could be looking for the end here. English now, no. BB Disco is able to fight his way out. And now BB Disco with a backbreaker, neckbreaker combination. Both men are down. BB Disco is looking for the tag. These fans are on their feet. Super Kenji finally gets his hand out. The tag is made. Super Kenji, down goes Aiden English. Down goes Simon Gusto. Simon Gotch once again with the resilience to hang on. BB Disco tried to react, but Aiden English was right there. The vaudevillains, as Simon Gotch calls the shot, it says end it right here. It's a wrap. He's got him on his shoulders. Aiden English connects. That may be the end of the match here because of this heads-up awareness. One, two, and three. The vaudevillains pick up a hard-earned victory.
Here are your winners, Aiden English and Simon Gotch, the vaudevillains.
Give them credit where it's due, ladies and gentlemen. The vaudevillains simply out-wrestled the Dance Floor Dangerous here tonight. The Dangerous weren't in good shape They didn't have time to prepare for their opponent, but the Quad Villains came in ready to strike, and the Quad Villains made the most of their opportunity. They are now, without a shadow of a doubt, the number one contenders.